Hi everyone, welcome back to our Digital Diaries. I'm Ahmed, Senior Content Producer for Africa's number one mining event, Mining Indaba. Today, we kick off a special six-part interview series all about Angola. Specifically, we will be speaking with His Excellency, the Honorable Dr. Diamantino Pedro Azevedo, Minister of Mineral Resources, Petroleum and Gas of the Republic of Angola, and delving into how Angola has enhanced its mining sector into a highly attractive and competitive market destination, as well as its current and evolving commodity strategies and how Angola plans to exploit its future mineral resources. Hello, Minister. Thank you for joining.
Thank you. Thank you. And it's as well for us a good opportunity that you are giving to the mining sector of Angola to present some important marks of the development of our mining sector in the last 5 years. And we expect that we can give you interesting news about what is happening and what we expect to happen in Angola in the next years to come.
To begin, the Angolan government has steadily introduced several positive regulatory changes that have been welcomed by the mining industry. My first question is, could you explore some of the key elements that have been changed within the amended regulatory framework?
Yes, that is really a very interesting question. And let me tell you that Angola has a great mining potential that could, in the long term, be a necessary industrial alternative for the country's development, considering the industry itself, as well as the various production chains brought by the prospecting, production, manufacturing, and marketing of the products. The Angolan government focus leans in placing the extracting mining industry of other mineral resources as an alternative for petroleum and also for diamonds. Since Angola is known as an oil and diamond country, and considering the changes occur in the mining sector over the last few years, there was a need for the Angolan government to create a new, robust and stable regulatory model adapted to the new reality. Thus, the Angolan government has introduced some positive regulatory change. With that regulatory changes that we introduced since the president of Angola, João Manuel Gonçalves Lourenço, took over the power 2017, we are facing already some results. That is to mention, for example, that we managed to attract companies like the Bias, who returned to the country, and Rio Tinto, Anglo-American, and a few other junior mining companies, and even small mining companies. That changes we did in the model of the governance of sector that allow us to attract investors were mainly to change the role of the government itself, which focus more on the policies and strategies. And we introduced new bodies on the structure, separating the functions of regulator and mining operator. And now we introduced the national regulatory body, the National Mineral Resources Agency, with the purpose of assuring the planning, preparation, launching of mining concession for the market, and negotiating mining contracts. Before, that function was for the ministry itself and for Indiama and another state-owned mining company. By now, Indiama, our national mining company, is not anymore that functions and becomes only a mining operator. We extinguish the another state-owned company, and now we have a more transparent structure that governs the mining sector in Angola. We also decide to introduce a new regulation to allow better development of diamond junior mining activities in the country. And we introduced a new regulation for the trading of diamonds. And we give the geological survey strong responsibilities. We are developing the national geology plan to increase the knowledge of the geology of the country. And all that changes that we did allow us also to become a member of the International Extractive Industry Transparency Initiative, and we continue to be a key player on the Kimberley process. With all the changes, we are seeing more companies, national and international companies, coming to Angola to look for greenfield, brownfield projects. And we are now in the process to even make that model better, so we can continue facing the challenges in the mining sector in the world.
Thank you again, Minister, for your time and for your insights. It has been a pleasure to discuss the thrilling developments within Angola, and I, for one, am looking forward to hearing more on how this new direction has developed at next year's Mining Indaba. For those of you that have joined us, thank you for tuning in. And if you have found what you have heard here interesting, then be sure to join us next year in Cape Town, where we'll be joined by the President of the Republic of Angola, His Excellency Juan Lorenzo, who will deliver a keynote address on the significant progress of Angola and its mining industry on Monday morning. For all things mining, stay tuned for more.